Good morning, Fords. I'm Maddie Culbertson.
And I'm Andrea Payne. Welcome to H Vision.
Happy 18th birthday, Andrea.
Thanks, it's good to be legal.
Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We'll now go to Jean Park for today's segment of Jean Jean the Weather Machine.
Good morning, Fords. I'm Jean Jean, the weather machine. Today is a gloomy Wednesday with a high of 57 but a low of 51. Although it's gloomy out, you're halfway through the week, Fords. Have a great day.
Today's pretty nice. The warm weather is definitely a change. Moving into sports announcements, boys varsity basketball beat CV West last night. Congrats, Fords.
Girls swim also had a victory defeating Agnes Irwin 100-71.
Make sure to join us for the quadruheader tomorrow night as boys and girls basketball take on Lower Merion. You can also watch all four games on Haverford Sports Media live broadcast.
Transitioning into clubs announcements, Interact will be having a meeting on Thursday after school in room 359.
Penn and Ink has a meeting today in room 126 until 3.
Best Buddies will be having a chapter meeting today after school.
The class of 2024 will be hosting a movie night in the auditorium this Friday at 5.
WHHS presents a karaoke night on December 16th from 7 to 8:30. Admission is $5.
Our first segment today is a feature I worked on. It's a review on one of my favorite movies, Home Alone. What's up, H Vision? My name is Maddie Culbertson.
And my name is Leah Stavrakis. If you're into action, comedy, and adventure movies, then we have the perfect one for you.
Yesterday, me and Lydia watched an old movie released in 1990 called Home Alone, created by John Hughes. It is a multi-sequel that was listed in the Guinness World Record at the highest live-action comedy ever as it was held till 2011.
8-year-old Kevin McAllister was played by actor Macaulay Culkin as the main character in Home Alone. And villains, Marv and Harry?
Yeah.
Were played by Daniel Stern and Joe Pesci, and they kind of stole the show a little bit. So around Christmas time, the McAllister family is preparing a trip to Paris for a family vacation. Kevin, who's like the troublemaker of the family, acts out and is forced to sleep on the third floor that night. Before closing the door, however, he makes a wish.
I don't want to see you again for the rest of my whole life, and I don't want to see anybody else either.
After the McAllisters miss their alarm and barely making it to their flight, mistakenly leaving Kevin, the family gets on a plane to Paris. Kevin awakens to an empty house and assumes his wish came true.
Being left home alone, Kevin was thrilled as he was watching gangster movies, eating pizza and ice cream, and jumping on his parents' bed, doing whatever he pleases.
But the fun wasn't over yet when two burglars, Marv and Harry, robbed several houses on the McAllister Street, and their house was next on the target.
Kevin acts quickly as he sets up booby traps to stop the burglars from getting into his house.
Personally, my favorite booby trap that Kevin set up was the one when he lit Harry's head on fire at the back door when it was being opened. Moments later, Harry gets feathers launched at him, making him look like a chicken. At that moment, Harry and Marv meet up for the first time after splitting up in the house and making fun of each other.
Where the hell did you take your shoes off?
Why the hell you dressed like a chicken?
Creating even more funny chaos.
I think mine is the tarantula scene. Kevin's brother, Buzz, has a spider that Kevin decides to let loose and climb on Marv. It's such a classic scene that never gets old. Even though it's not necessarily a trap, the scene where he plays the lines from the movie he's watching is another favorite. My family and I quote that scene all the time.
Keep the change, you filthy animal.
Yeah, I love that scene. The various shots and angles in the movie really add to the development by showing the viewers mostly what's going to happen before. Like when Marv was walking up the steps and the viewers saw the noun he was about to step on before he actually did. It built up a lot of worry and anticipation on behalf of the audience.
I also think the soundtrack has a huge role in the anticipation of the movie. Like, my family, I feel like we play this song, especially in the beginning of the movie, all the time.
Yeah.
And we were just talking earlier about that scene when they all wake up and they realize they're late and the music is so fast-paced.
And then they like are like zooming through the house. It's just really cool.
Yeah, and if you didn't know, the soundtrack was done by John Wayne. He's done a ton of movies like Jaws, Home Alone, Indiana Jones. Like, he is very
Jurassic
famous.
Park, yeah.
He's very famous, and this is probably one of his most well-known soundtracks.
Yeah, definitely.
So overall, I'd say this movie is pretty fantastic, not to mention just a classic. I think it has to be a 10 out of 10 just because of how memorable and easily quotable it is. I feel like everyone I know watches it around the holidays, which makes it like a tradition.
Yeah, Home Alone is one of my favorite movies of all time. Overall, the movie is a 10 out of 10, and it's a movie I watch all the time, at least once a month. Once the winter hits and the holidays start, it is my go-to Christmas movie, and I watch it almost 3 to 4 times a month. I highly recommend watching this movie. Go see it now.
I agree. It's a great movie. Go watch it now!
I like Marv.
So do I.
Our next feature is a search for the best holiday drinks.
Hi, I'm Felicia D'Amico.
And I'm Jack Gunnarazzi, and today we are trying to find the best holiday drink. We have narrowed it down to Starbucks, Dunkin', and Wawa.
And we have decided to rate them on a 5-star scale. Our first drink is from Wawa. I'm a bee under the mistletoe. Will you? Shawty, will you? Will you? Shawty, will you? Will you? Under the mistletoe. Everyone's gathering around the fire. Chestnuts roasting like a hot July. Ice peppermint mocha from
Wawa.
Let's try it out. Really good.
It's really good.
And it even has little candy canes. Yes, it has candy canes on the bottom. And it's so cute. It's a perfect amount of sweet.
Yeah.
And I would get it again.
Yeah, I would rate it a 3.8 out of 5.
Yes, agreed. 3.8 out of 5. Next, we went to Dunkin' and we got the cookie butter cold brew coffee.
That's good.
I don't know.
I think it's good.
I don't know if I like it. I think it's kind of cinnamony.
Cinnamony? I don't think it tastes cinnamony. I am getting the cookie butter. Like, I do taste the cookie butter, but I feel like it's a little too sweet for my liking.
I would rate that one like a 3 out of 5.
A 3.2 out of 5.
I really like it. I think it's like a 4.2. I like the hint of ginger. It's giving eggnog vibes.
Last, we are trying the
iced sugar cookie almond milk latte.
It tastes like popcorn. It's awful.
Hold on. That's horrible. I would rate this like a 3 out of 5. I like it, but like I was expecting the sugar cookie. It does not taste like sugar cookie.
And I rate it like a 1 out of 5. We decided that Wawa is the winner. We hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to go check out the new holiday drinks. Thank you for watching.
All of those drinks looked so good, but I'm going to have to stick with the classic hot mug. But I'm going to have to stick with the classic mug of hot chocolate.
With or without marshmallows?
With the.
Okay.
Oh, our final segment is an interview with the science teacher, Miss Marshall.
Today we're here with the one, the only, Miss Marshall. Thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you for interviewing me, Jean.
First question, where did you grow up and where do you live currently?
I grew up outside of Wilkes-Barre in Scranton, so it's about 2 hours north of here in a tiny little town called Wyoming. And I currently live in Brookhaven, right near Lynn Villa. And Miss Mortland lives like a half a mile away from me, so we are neighbors.
Wow. Not Wyoming the state, but
not
just
Wyoming, Wyoming, Pennsylvania.
What did you want to be when you were younger, and how has that changed?
I wanted to be an orthopedic surgeon and then be the surgeon for like a sports team. That was a goal of mine. But here I am with you.
I was going to say, how did that turn into apes?
It turned into apes because I went to school for biology.
Right.
And then in the midst of all of that was kind of squeamish around blood and stuff. So figured, hey, probably not going to become a surgeon. And then when I was at Delaware, I became a teaching assistant for an undergraduate lab and had a good time teaching. And I was like, I'll give that gig a go around and see how it goes. And here I am. How many years are we? 16 years later.
What is your favorite dream vacation destination?
Ooh, a dream vacation destination. I would really love to go throughout Europe and see all the different countries there. But I also really want to do Hawaii. So I'm going to go Hawaii as like the ultimate dream vacation because it's farther away and probably a heck of a lot more expensive than to go to Europe.
Anywhere specifically in Europe?
No. Everywhere.
You could just go backpacking.
Yeah.
All around, yeah. What is your favorite meal to cook?
Ooh. My favorite meal to cook is probably what I'm making this weekend is Thanksgiving dinner. So I really...
What's on the menu?
On the menu, we have turkey, we have stuffing, we have sweet potatoes, we've got like glazed carrots.
Wow.
I also purchased, and you have to Google this, Baskin and Robbins makes...
the turkey cake?
I bought it. Yes. So the turkey cake will be at my house. Yeah, but it's worth it.
It's worth it.
For picking out the ice cream flavor.
So, what flavor did you get?
I did the, I think it's called Gold Ribbon, where it's like vanilla chocolate and has like a caramel swirl through it.
Favorite artist?
I'll make you happy by saying that I feel like I'm a pseudo Swifty. I love some T-Swift, but old school, like childhood me, I really like Janet Jackson.
Some classic
Janet from back in the 80s, 90s, and then today, a little T-Swift.
Amazing. Thank you so much.
You are welcome. Thank you.
I had Ms. Marshall for environmental science, and I loved her. She puts her students first, and it really shows.
She sounds great.
Well, that's all for today.
Have a great day, Fords.